Whenever current flows through a conductor, a magnetic field expands around the conductor. If the current is small, the magnetic field does not expand outward as far. If the current increases, the magnetic field expands and increases in strength. When current is first switched on, a magnetic field starts to build up from the center of the wire and expands outward. When current stops flowing, the magnetic field contracts inward until, when the current reaches zero, the magnetic field disappears completely. This expansion or contraction of the magnetic field as the current varies is a movement of flux lines through a conductor. In each case, as the flux lines expand from the center or contract back to the center, the flux lines are cutting through the conductor. Flux lines moving through a conductor is the essential requirement for electromagnetic induction. However, unlike normal induction, this kind of induction occurs on its own without the action of an external magnetic field. For this reason, it is called electromagnetic self-induction. Self-induction, just as externally produced electromagnetic induction, results in an EMF. This EMF of self-induction is much more pronounced if a conductor is coiled, because the individual flux lines combine and the magnetic field is concentrated and stronger. When current first begins to flow in a circuit that contains a coil of wire, the flux lines build up. As the current builds to maximum, flux lines expand outward and cut through the nearby coils of the wire. This action self-induces a voltage back into the coils that produce the magnetic field. Because of its ability to produce self-induced voltage, a coil of wire is called an inductor. An inductor, therefore, can be defined as a coil producing self-induced voltage. Because of the direction in which the flux lines are moving, the voltage induced back into the coil has a polarity opposite that of the source voltage. This self-induced voltage, then, pushes against the current that is beginning to flow and delays the current as it builds to its maximum value. This voltage is called a back EMF, counter voltage or counter EMF, abbreviated C-emf. Once the source current has built to its maximum value, the magnetic field stops expanding and the flux lines no longer cut through the coils. With no relative movement, no counter voltage is induced. This is called the steady state. The steady state occurs when source current is no longer increasing or changing value. The time that elapses when a circuit is first switched on and the current builds from zero to its maximum value is known as the transient state. During the transient state, current is changing, the magnetic field is moving, and counter-electromotive force is induced into an inductor. The transient state occurs again when source current is switched off and drops from its maximum value to zero. In the process, the magnetic field surrounding the entire inductor, as well as each loop, collapses back down into the conductor. Each flux line cuts back through the other coils of the inductor, inducing CEMF back into the coils. Since the magnetic field is collapsing inward, the polarity of the CEMF is opposite what it was when current was beginning to flow and the field was expanding outward. The counter voltage in this case tends to keep current flowing in its original direction. This voltage can actually be many times higher than the source voltage because the field collapses so quickly and is sometimes called an inductive kick. This inductive kick can actually be visible when an arc or spark jumps across the contacts of a switch that is opened. Here, the counter EMF induced by the collapsing magnetic field is so high it arcs across the switch contacts.